Hi, I'm Matt Barm and welcome back to the BOM Movies presentation of Skyrim. Okay, here we are in Ravenrock. And in the last episode, we got the ancient Nordic pickaxe. So I went back down into the mine and I mined the Starrim that was there. So we've now got lots of Starrim and I've put it on the horse.
Artur,
he now has all of the ore. He now has an awful lot of stuff actually on him. I'm surprising he's still standing up and not falling over. And companions are still talking a lot to each other. As always, even Freya. So we're with Freya, we're with Bilya, and we're with Inigo, but I have no familiars or conjured companions. We've got a couple of things left to do in Ravenrock at the moment. We've got to find a couple of people to drink the Sujama that Geldus gave us from the Retching Netch. And when I was back down in the mine, I actually found Netch jelly down there. Enough to give it to the apothecary lady in here. Or man. Ah, it's locked. So let's knock. It is night time. I wanted to get this finished. May I come in?
Of course.
Although some say she left the temple.
Awesome. Right, so we can go in here and give them the Netch jelly. I think it's Mylor I need to give it to. I can't remember whether it was the lady or the man. They're probably in bed. It is night time, so I'm going to rudely awaken them. So I wanted to get these things done and then head into the inn, talk to Geldus. Yeah, they're in bed. Sorry to disturb you. Yes, it is the lady, isn't it?
I don't know who sent you here, but you've given us something to build on here. I hope someday we can repay you for your kindness.
You're welcome, and I've got that Netch jelly for you.
Goodness, it must have been quite difficult tracking those creatures down out there.
These. I found it in
they
the mine.
They should help you during your journeys.
Awesome. Okay, well that's that done. So I need to find two more people, I think it is. A couple more people to drink the Sujama, and then we can head back into the inn. So I need to search for some people to drink the Sujama. I'm wondering who. I don't know whether the guards will drink the Sujama. Let's talk to one of the guards.
If you've got any gripes, check in at Morbay Manor. Second Councillor Arano will sort you out.
No, I've already been in there and I've already given them the Sujama. So who else can we give the Sujama to? Let's have a look at Alor House, see if they'll let me in.
Is someone there?
Yes, it's Turgon. May I come in?
Of course.
Thank you. Although I don't think I've met you yet, and you're just opening up your house to me. I could be a murderer. Well, I am a murderer. Of evil people. Does that still count as being a murderer? I guess it does. I mean, that's a bit of a moral dilemma, isn't it? I mean, is it still murder, even though you're killing people who are evil? I suppose it is. Sorry to wake you, but I've got a drink for you to send you right back to sleep.
The mines are open and the shop is busy again. Thank you.
Well, I haven't even looked at your shop, Drayla, but have a drink on me.
At least my father will let me drink whatever I want without complaining. Tell Geldus I appreciate it.
You're not sleeping in the same bed as your father,
safe.
Are you?
Solstheim's still a dangerous place.
Maybe they've got different ethics. Hello.
It's busier now that things are starting to look up. I guess I might stay a bit longer after all.
Here is a drink for you to help you go back to sleep.
Geldus needs to bottle this up and send it to the mainland instead of wasting his time out here. His drinks are outstanding. Thanks.
Awesome. Okay, that's that done. However, how are things now that the mines are open again?
Things are picking
up to me.
For now. All I'm wondering is how long it'll take for House Redoran to begin ignoring us again if the mine runs out of ore for a second time.
I don't think it's going to run out. I was down there earlier on and it's full of ore, loads of ebony ore. I also mined lots of ebony ore from down there. Do you sell any special mining gear?
Mining gear? No. However, I used to sell East Empire pendants until I ran out of them. Popular little item.
Okay, what's an East Empire pendant? Although I do have at least
it's
one.
It's an amulet that was made exclusively for the
you
East Empire.
You had a notice
Empire
on the
company.
Notice board, didn't you?
They gave them to their workers as an incentive at one point. A kind of reward for extra effort. They're no longer being made, so they've become a collectible. I'd love to get my hands on a few of them.
I'll sell you some of mine.
Well, well. Seems you're proving fairly useful for an outlander. Here's your coin.
Thank you, I guess.
Keep bringing me more, and I'll keep paying you for them.
All right, then. Superb. Oh, that's 500 septims. Yes, as I was saying, that was 500 septims for one of those. Thank you very much, Fethys.
The East Empire pendants are scattered all over, so leave no stone unturned.
I will not look for them as a priority, but if I come across any, I'll come back to you and sell them to you. For 500 septims.
Even now, the Omega watches over us.
Indeed. And that was a bit of a happy jiggle, wasn't it, Vilya? Just out of character for a second, Skyrim just minimised to the desktop again, which is why there was a brief interruption there. Not sure why it's doing that. I think something must be cooling Windows. And it's just minimising to the desktop. It's done it before, once. But anyway, we are back. Okay, I think it's time to go in the inn and speak to Geldis and tell him that we've managed to get 10 people drunk. And also, can he let a drunk back into the inn?
Warm drinks and warm beds.
He probably will, seeing as we've got 10 people drunk on his Sujama.
Welcome to the Retching Nets Corner Club, home of the finest Sujama that will ever grace your lips.
Hi, Geldis. Yes, I've been here before, although it looks like you might have eye problems. So, why did you... first of all, why did you ban Brassler Drell from your inn?
Have you seen the poor girl? She's a mess.
Yeah, she's just down on her luck.
Oh, she used to be richer than Councillor Morvane.
Really?
And she's spending it all drowning in sorrow. As much as I love making coin, I can't watch her do that anymore. I won't.
Okay, that sounds fair enough, actually. However, she does have the right to do what she wants.
I suppose you're right. If she wants to spend her life at the bottom of an ale mug, it's her choice.
It is her choice.
She's welcome back any time.
But you are a man of high moral fibre, and I'm quite glad about that, actually. I've given out the Sadra's Sujama as requested.
Perfect. All that's left now is to go ahead and wait for the patrons to come in.
Awesome.
As promised, here's a little something for yourself.
More Sujama? No, 500 septims. You're all giving 500 septims out. That's quite a good thing. How are things now that the mines are open again?
How do you think? It's a blessing.
So where's my car?
I've got regular paying customers again. Thirsty workers at the end of the day, and more coin than I can count.
Send some coin my way, although I don't think I'm lacking in the coin front. I'll have to have a look in a second. I'd like to rent a room, Geldis, but first of all... Oh, you don't want to fill my water. Okay, I'd like to rent a room.
Sure thing.
If you want to it's yours for a day. Goods
you want to fill my water now? No, you don't. Okay, fine. I will just have a room then.
I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
Okay. First of all, before I go into my room, let's just have a look how much money... 104,000 gold! And so much stuff to sell as well. I'm going to be a millionaire by the time we leave Solstheim. Awesome! Have to worry about money for a while, guys. Okay, I'm presuming it's this room. Okay, Vilya, Freya, come join me. And here you go. Try and stay out here or something. Get drunk. Bedtime. So, we do have a few things to do around Solstheim. We're going to go and talk to the lass who wanted to get back into the Retching Netch. We're going to tell her the good news, and hopefully she won't drink as much anymore. Although the mines are now open, so she'll probably be alright. And
let me know if there's anything else you need.
Was he watching me all night as well as Inigo? Who knows? Who knows? And then we've got a couple of other things we need to investigate. We're going to go to somewhere called Coalborn, I think it is. And we've also got to find one of the Skull villagers who went missing. And we've also got to investigate Frostmoon Crag, I think it is, as well. So we're going to talk to the lady that wanted to come into the Retching Netch first. Tell her the good news. And then we're going to head out of...
Sometimes I get homesick when I'm thinking...
Head out of Raven Rock that direction, which that is understandable. Actually...
Don't you ever get homesick?
Which direction is that? I would like to say east. No, but it's not. It's kind of...
Is that true?
East, southeast, isn't it? Southeast, south, southeast. Whatever. That way. That's the way we're going. I was actually pointing at the monitor there. Sorry, out of character. Okay.
Really?
Right.
Yes, Vilya. I like Skyrim very much, It is where my new beginning began.
Okay, let's try and find that lady.
You face danger without hesitation.
Was it this one?
Just so you know it.
It was! Rustler!
I'm a different person.
We make it good.
And I have you to thank for it.
You are welcome. And you're also welcome at the Wretched Next anytime.
Well then, I suppose I'm off to do what I do best. Here, this was something I carried around in happier times. Maybe you can find a use for it.
Glass Warhammer of Despair. So how are things now that the mines are open?
Couldn't be better.
Good.
The sections that are being opened up have revealed some huge deposits of ebony.
Yes, I noticed.
Old Crecius has a nose for exactly where to dig. If they'd only listened to him years ago, the town wouldn't have been in such dire straits.
Well, I did listen to him.
This way, I'll be able to put a roof over my head in just a few months.
Yeah, sorry, Brassler, but we almost got struck by lightning. What on earth is going on? It's not a dragon, is it? No. That's a mage light. Okay, that's insane. Look at that. Right, we're going this way. And we're going this way quickly. Because I believe Coalborn... Is it Coalborn? Let's have a look at the map. Yes. Coalbjorn. Arrow. We're going that way. And we're going to investigate on our way. So you've helped out quite a few people in Raven Rock now. Which is quite pleasing. Let's see who else we can help out.
I'll get a Sujama. It's very, well, special.
We will, Vilya, we will. In fact, I've probably got some. I see one of the Redoran Guard fighting some ash spawn. Let's assist. Let's assist. I'm making arrow noises then. I don't know whether that recorded or not. Oh dear, right. Yes, dead, and give me your souls. Have they actually got souls? Interesting. Let's help whoever that is. Okay, Captain Vele. Right.
I wish I could have said the same for my man here.
He wasn't sure if he'd get off this farm alive, is what he just said. And Skyrim just minimised to the desktop again, which is really weird. It's only happened once in a few episodes ago. This happened twice this episode, so I might have to look at why that is happening. Anyway, let's continue, Captain Veleth.
Thanks. I wasn't sure I'd make it off this farm alive. I wish I could have said the same for my man here.
What were those things?
Some of the Redoran Guard have taken to calling them ash spawn. Me, I don't care what they're called. All I know is they're a danger to Raven Rock and they need to be stopped.
Indeed they are. How did that bring you to this old farm? You're probably searching for clues.
I was going to search for clues that might lead me to wherever they're coming from. I know it isn't the best place to start, but we know they've been coming from this direction.
Okay, I'm not going to ask for money because I'm loaded, so I'll be glad to lend you a hand.
Good. I can use all the help I can get.
And I quite
Besides,
like
Besides, I don't feel comfortable leaving Raven Rock behind.
You've got a
And I'd hate to lose any more veteran accent. Guard.
Very well. Where do I begin?
We were searching the farm when the Aspawn ambushed us. Have a look around and see if you can turn up anything useful.
You've got a lot of soldiers here that can help you, or guards that can help you. What are these Aspawn?
No one knows, really. Superstitious folks say they're the risen forms of those that died long ago. But I'm not so certain. They started attacking the bulwark a few weeks ago. My men were able to kill them, but they keep coming back.
How often do they attack?
We've had two other assaults on the bulwark, at different spots on the wall.
Right.
I know it sounds crazy, but it's almost like they're becoming more organized and probing it for weaknesses.
Someone is orchestrating this and controlling them. You suspect there's a motivation to their attacks?
Exactly. Something has to be directing them against us, and we need to find out who or what it is.
Okay. So why do you think the attacks are from the Atius farm?
I don't. All I know is that the Aspawn are coming from this direction.
Logical.
So this is as good a place to start as anywhere else.
Yes, I agree.
Good thing the farm's been abandoned for a long time. I'd hate to see what they would do to an unarmed farmer and his family.
Yes, I'd hate to see that as well. How long has the farm been abandoned?
Not sure. I was told it was an old Imperial farm that was wiped out by the eruption of the Red Mountain.
Maybe.
Not certain who lived there. It was already a pile of rubble when I arrived in Raven Rock.
Okay, so where are you from? How are things now that the mines are open again for you, although you probably don't even know?
I've had to muster some more men to protect the mine.
Oh, you do
but
know.
I don't really have a problem with that. Second Councillor Arano is concerned that once word reaches the Reavers that the mine has reopened, they might think about paying us a visit.
Right.
I say let them try. My men are ready for them.
Okay. Nice to meet you, Captain.
Report back to me if you discover anything unusual.
I shall indeed. But first of all, I'm going to loot these ash piles. Declaration of War. Ravenrock Stronghold. Upon my honour, I do swear undying loyalty to the Emperor. My calls for the unconditional surrender of your forces and an immediate cessation of all hostilities have been ignored numerous times. I therefore have no choice but to assume your purpose and self-statement is hostile, and to treat Ravenrock Stronghold as an enemy of the Empire. I warn you, any attempt to breach Fort Frostmoth will be met by an equal level of aggression. I will do everything in my power to wipe you and your forces off the face of Tamriel. There will be no further communications between us. General Fulcarius. Fulcarius. Garrison Commander Fort Frostmoth. Okay. You don't seem very nice. So I've got to give the note to Captain Veleth. Okay, Captain, found something
have
already.
You found something?
Yes. I discovered this note on one of the Ashbourne.
This is strange.
It is.
The note says it's from General Fulcarius. But that's impossible.
Why is that impossible?
Well, Carius was the Imperial Garrison Commander at Fort Frostmoth. But he died over 200 years ago when the Red Mountain leveled the place.
Right.
There's no way he could still be alive.
What do you want me to do, although I can guess?
If General Carius is still alive, there must be something keeping him that way. I need you to head out to Fort Frostmoth and check it out. I'm going to head back to Raven Rock and prepare the men for further assaults.
You do that. I will head over to the fort and I will check it out.
Be careful. This General Carius sounds out of his mind.
He does a bit. Okay, let's search the rest of these ash piles. And this Redoran guard. So is this bone mould armour actually any good? It looks quite good. It also weighs quite a lot, however, I'm going to take it. Because I want a set of that. What? Doing what? I didn't do anything. Well, I took his armour, but he doesn't need it anymore. Look, he doesn't need it. See?
This is fun.
Right, let's have a look at this farm anyway, see if there's anything in the farmstead. Just some stuff to harvest. Okay, let's continue on this way. Where is Frostmoth Fort anyway? There. Fort Frostmoth. Okay, so we're nearly at the Coldjorn Barrow. Let's go and see what's going on up here.
What makes this smell?
Ash hopper. So all of their armour is made from those ash creatures. We've got to talk to some guy up here. Wherever he may be. I can hear someone mining. Aha! This must be the one. Hello!
Just leave me be.
No. I heard you were starting an expedition.
Who told you that? Was it Galdis?
Probably.
I told that idiot not to send me anymore.
Anymore?
It probably can't hurt to tell you. You look mostly honest.
I look kind of red-eyed and beastly.
Rallus Sidaris.
Rallus.
I've got a financier waiting for me back on the mainland. Sent me here in the interests of obtaining some rare antiquities. The relics of Arzador. But this whole thing became a disaster right quick, let me tell you.
What happened?
You come out of the Northern Ashlands, you don't expect things to go easy, you know. But this was something outside my particular expertise. When I first got to Kolbjorn, you couldn't even see it. Buried in the ash, like most other things on this blasted island.
Yes, I noticed that.
A pile of the stuff taller than me just to find the barrel. Who knows how much to reach the door? Excavating isn't exactly my specialty. Even if it was, the ash storms fill it in faster than you can dig.
Why not hire some of the miners out of Raven Rock?
You think I've got that kind of money?
You said you had a financier.
No, I only get paid on delivery. Can't afford to go out of pocket for 1,000 septimums.
Don't start helping him, Freya. He's not paying us.
Takes money to make
Freya.
Money all that rot. There's a lot of it at the other end. But I can't get there without a little kick to start it off.
Okay, here we go. I have got lots of money. But what is this treasure you're after?
You ever hear of Arzador?
Yes.
He was the first great Nord enchanter. Maybe even the first human to master Elven methods. His best work was buried with him, though. A set that my patron calls the relics are supposed to be down in his tomb. Now, they're old, and they're powerful. A combination like that makes them pretty valuable to certain people. And I happen to know certain people.
Okay, well, I've got some money, Rallus. Are you looking for a partner?
What? Are you serious?
A bit of a nervous laugh.
I think I could make that work.
You've got ulterior motive, haven't you?
We can sort out the details of our arrangement later. But for now, I'll manage the dig if you can manage the coin.
And what's that book
over
there?
Do you have the gold?
Yes, I do. Here you go.
It's all here. Well then, looks like I have a good bit of work to start on. I'll head back to Raven Rock and round up some diggers. Once we've got something worth looking at, I'll send word to you.
You do that.
Pleasure doing business with you, partner. I'll see you soon.
And you've got an ancient Nordic pickaxe. Oh, that's what you look like. Why are you wearing leather armor?
Look, this can be a slow business. Digging takes time. Come around later and I'll have something more interesting.
You probably will, won't you? There's a book down here. Can you,
My thoughts are always with my people.
He's not watching, is he? No, he's not. Quickly, let's read this. The Journal of Rallus Sidaris. Volume 19. Moving on to Solstheim next. Chasing after vague rumours of this cold-born barrow. My patron seems confident we can find the relics of Azidal out here. But I am a bit skeptical. But so long as he pays well, I'll dig wherever the old coot likes. Initial prospects look poor, to say the least. I was sure I had my map wrong at first, until it became clear that the place had just been lost to the ash. I'll dig out as much as I can, maybe see if I can recruit some of the local residents to help me out. I haven't seen anyone since I got out of Raven Rock, but I keep hearing conversations and whispers around me, so I just need to track them down. I'm taking that. And he didn't see. Good. Right. You'll probably just think he's mislaid it and start a new one. Right, you go and get some diggers, and you better not waste my money down the wretching netch or anywhere else. And what's the next thing, guys? Let's have a look. Well, we could go and check out Fort Frostmouth. But we have only just found out about that, although the Ashborn attacks are quite desperate, really. Though we haven't explored around here at all. I think we should go straight south and explore and work our way round to the fort. Yes, let's do that. Let's go this way. And see what we can see. See, there's a big boat over there. That might be worth exploring. doesn't look very friendly. There's lots of these Redoran guard everywhere, which is quite good. Kind of makes me feel a bit safer, although not really need to feel safe, because I am the Dragonborn. But what is this place over here then? Okay, and are they friendlies? Let's just do a premonition save. I don't think they are friendlies. No, they're not.
Uh-oh. Look.
They're attacking. Right, let's go. You're dead. You're nearly dead. Yeah. Get out of the way. Whoa. Dead. Is that it? No, there are more, apparently. Well, I think that's it. So what is this place we just kind of destroyed? Let's have a look. Villia, you've been shot to pieces. This is the wreck of the Strident Squall. Don't we need to come here to get a diary or something? Let me just help you there, Villia. That looks very painful, as normal. Okay, good. Right, let's have a look at what these people were holding. Causes a shock explosion. Oh, that sounds good. Bits of Nordic armor again. I do like the Nordic armor, and it is pretty good stuff. I'm going to run out of room, and I've probably already got some Nordic armor, but we'll see. We shall see. Just loot all these people. Okay, what else is down in this section? Look at that strange heartstone. Okay. And there's a couple of people here as well. Reaver Thug. It's an armor of eminent conjuration. I quite like that armor. Okay. Anything else up here? I don't know why there's so much lightning. This is kind of overcast, but not many thunder clouds, rain clouds. It's just an electrical storm without any clouds. Why are you running around with your sword out, amigo? Fat coin purses! Nice. We like a good fat coin purse. Bit of food, a couple of books that I've read. Okay.
Honestly. Some bandits are so silly. They always hang around in the same old places. You might as well have your bow ready when you walk up to them.
This is true, Villia, this is true. And I usually do have my bow ready, actually, when I walk up to them. Okay, any books that we haven't read here? The Sea. Kettle, I don't want the kettle, I don't want the lantern. But there is one of these East Empire strong boxes. Okay, there, sort of. There? No, there. Down a little bit more, that should be it. Yep, pop! Okay. Because of aiming. Like that. Gonna have fun disenchanting these that I've picked up and adding them to various other weapons and armour. Although I probably won't be doing that until I've reached Skyrim again. Okay, we might have an Uber chest of loveliness over there, but let's have a look elsewhere first. Is there anything else behind here? We've got to go down there, but that's going to be freezing cold water. Probably not a good idea. Let's have a look in the chest first. Cabbage stew and a Nordic arrow. Okay. Lusty Argonian made folio. Interesting. The Lusty Argonian made folioed edition. To the Arano family, when I showed up on your doorstep in Morrowind that day, I expected to be thrown back into the street and cast aside like some sort of vermin. Instead, you offered me into the warmth and safety of your home. For that, I will be eternally grateful. Please accept this rare folio edition of my work as a sign of appreciation for your kindness. Gracias Curio. Okay. That's awesome. So we found the folio. Cool. Right. Good stuff. Let's get wet. And I have a premonition that I might die. So I'm just going to use the premonition saver. This is going to be freezing. What is there down here? Anything special? Probably not. Steps going up. Yes. Feel chilly, really? Giant's toe. Nothing else. There is a satchel there. Apothecary satchel. Scimitar and a knapsack. Dragon scale mage circlet. Okay, nothing else up here. No, let's get wet again. Billy, you really shouldn't be following me down here. There, you're going to catch your death of cold. We can't go down there. Right, back down this way. Oh, trapped this way. Right, not good. I'm going to be frozen, but it is still daylight outside, I think. But we need to make our way. Did I check that chest? No, I didn't. Missed the chest. Oops. Make our way up to the falls, I think. Oh, for goodness sake, that's got to be it. Yep. Pop.
Excellent work.
Why, thank you, Inigo. You are super impressed by my lock-picking skills at all times. Yeah, right. Okay, so... there is Neloth's house over there. Have a look at the map. So, basically, we need to head over... east. But let's head over east. This way. What's that there?
What makes this smell?
Inigo. And you were standing next to him as well. You should have figured that out by now, Vilya. Really should have figured that out. Okay, what's this?
Whoa.
Road of South. There was no other way it could end. Not with us four. Okay, so we found someone's house. Well, we're going to loot said house. There's a trap door there into Roldolf's cellar. We'll have to go and have a look. In a second. Ah, oh, for goodness sake. Was that... wasn't in the middle, was it? Oh, for goodness sake. Did really try the middle first. I'm going to be full soon. Okay, there's not a lot else here. There is that trap door. Looks like there's some Sujama or Flynn. Flynn! Okay, let's have a look in Rogulf's cellar. See what's down here. Wonder if there's anything exciting down here. No, not really. Some empty wine bottles.
I knew it!
What?
And some people! Highwaymen! Dead and... ooh, nice!
Dead!
Okay, I hope we didn't need to talk to those people. Well, it's a bit late now if we did. Okay. Fine. Right. What were they hiding down here? This looks like quite a nice little place to spend the evening, you know? Bit messy, but at least they've left some food on the table. Is that a note? A letter to Rodolf from Bjornolf. Rodolf, light and strength. I feel your words are not your own, and I worry dearly for your health. I beg of you, please depart that blasted isle and return to solitude at once. My nights have been almost impossible to bear without you. To lose you would be the death of me. My love, if you do not return soon, I will come for you. Okay. You'll take your food and eat it. Lockpicks and knapsack. I think we'll probably spend the night here. Have a look at what the time is. All those books all over the floor. Dwarves Volume 2 that we haven't read. I really do want to read some of these books. Ode to the Tundra Striders. Cats of Skyrim? Is that Puddy Cats? Okay. And we have Herodov's Journal. Steel plate helmet. Needed one of those. Okay, Bowman Milk Shield, probably got one, and lockpicks and septins. What's empty barrels? Right, let's read a whole Roldulf's journal. Hopefully it's not too long. One, I've arrived in Solstheim and moved into an old house on the hill by the shore. Whoever lived here before is long gone. I can see well out into the waters from my vantage here, and I can hear all things behind and around. Dumber bandits wander the woods at night, but I don't fear them. There is a calling from the depth, a rumble drone that sings to me at night. I've started sleeping in the basement and keeping a knife near. The call is loudest. Down here, I will be ready for whatever is coming. It is as if a great machine reverberates beneath me. I tire of waiting for the caller underneath to emerge. I walked to town, I bought some digging tools, shovel, pick. Two shovels and a pick? I started to break down the wall behind the bookshelf and dig down slow. I put the bookshelf back when I finished digging. Why? No house guests here, but I feel I have something to hide. How can I make Bjorn hear what I have heard? I must not lose him yet. I must remain in this place, for I know I will know the truth soon. The murmurer in the earth and I will we talk. I lay my head against the dirt, fire from the deep. Okay, that's nonsensical at the end there, really. Pretty hard to read too. Yeah, strange. Something happened here, and it appears to be behind this bookshelf. Okay, let's go and have a look. There's one of the shovels. There's a Dwemer machine. And Bjornolf. Oh dear. Letter to Bjorn. Bjorn, do not come to this place. I have not much self left. The earth will take us both. He killed her. Him. He killed him. Oh, he did leave some septims. Thanks. Oh, there is a chest here as well. Elven Warhammer Enduring Fire. So what is this place then? Dwarven metal ingots. And a chest. Okay, something Dwemer. Not sure what exactly. Lots and lots. Okay, that wasn't such a bad chest. Alright, I have no idea what all this is about. Maybe we'll find out more at a later date.
No matter where the road takes us,
this is very strange.
My thoughts are at home.
Freya, you are at home, sort of. You're not far. Like 5 minutes up the road. Okay, but it still doesn't seem like a bad place to spend the night. What is the time? It's 6:10. I think, guys, there's enough room here for all of us. There's a sleeping bag there for an ego, and there's one there for us three. right. Let's shut this just in case. Let's have something to eat, put our heads down for the night, and then we'll head off to Frostmouth Fort tomorrow. And of course, a little bit later on. And what were you smiling there for, Turkin? You didn't have to stop smiling, not on my account.